I think Vaughan Williams is the most underestimated, the most misunderstood of all the great 20th century English composers. Elgar could certainly still do with a bit of readjusting of his image. Britain, the process has begun in a way since his death, a re-evaluation and reassessment. But Vaughan Williams, this cosy teddy bear, like a kind of overinflated John Betjeman figure, you know, that really is a frightful injustice.
What a complex and disturbing artist he is. A man who wrote some of the most deeply unsettling music of our time.
The 2007 Sony Radio Academy UK Station of the Year. This is Classic FM. All this weekend, we're counting down the top 300 pieces of classical music, as voted for by you, the Classic FM Hall of Fame with Simon Bates.
We have another British composer as the most popular in the Classic FM Hall of Fame 2007. Two of his compositions in the top 10, and this at number one, Ralph Vaughan Williams with The Lark Ascending.
I do think one of the qualities that comes over most remarkably about Vaughan Williams is his courage. If you think about that pastoral idyll he'd celebrated in The Lark Ascending, clearly there's an elegiac character. Well, the whole idea of pastoral in English poetry is elegiac for a start. But I think it's also an elegy for that vanished idea of the English countryside as Eden, that the pastoral life was one that would go on forever and ever. I think Vaughan Williams maybe hoped that it would at first. I think he became pretty sure that it wouldn't, that irrevocable change had happened.
And therefore,
there is a sense of him contemplating the worst that might befall, the possibility that there is no meaning, that there is no answer, that there will be no vision in the moment of death which explains our life to us, no reconciliation with God, that the unknown region may be just emptiness or nothingness, that this little life is rounded with something possibly even worse than a sleep.